I went from a junior analyst at 20 years old, not knowing any SQL, to being promoted into a head of data position by the time that I was 27. And no, not because I wrote perfect queries or that I built fancy machine learning models. And definitely not because I was an Asian female, according to my haters. If you are a data analyst or data scientist and you want to stand out and get promoted quickly, then this video is for you. Because truth is, the top 1% of data professionals rise quickly, not because they're technically good, but because they think strategically, communicate clearly, and solve real business problems. And in this video, I'm going to walk you through my step-by-step playbook that helped me climb up the corporate ladder quickly and how you can do the same thing. First things first, let me get this straight. No one is getting promoted for generating reports or building machine learning models. A great data analyst or data scientist doesn't just generate numbers, they solve business problems. They know exactly who their work impacts, how it's going to be used, and what decisions need to come out of it. Let's say you're building a churn model. That's pretty cool. But do you actually understand how churn impacts your business? What are the financial impacts? How your model is going to be applied? And which team actually owns customer retention? If not, my advice for you is to think like a consultant. Get really curious and comfortable understanding how your business actually makes money, where the friction is, what the customer journey looks like, and how data can actually help. And this mindset shift alone will put you ahead of 90% of other analysts. And now you might be wondering, that's all great, but how do we put this into practice? Now, one thing that really helped me was pausing before diving into solution mode. I would ask key questions like, what are we really trying to solve here? What does success look like? Which stakeholders are going to see this? And what do they actually care about? Basically, what is the business problem that we are trying to solve here with data? Because the best data analysts don't just dive into the analysis. They define the problem, challenge assumptions, and help guide the conversation. And that is exactly the kind of thinking that gets you pulled into strategic conversations and potential promotions. Moving on, let's talk about communication and storytelling. Arguably the most underrated skill in any industry. You can build the most advanced model in the world, but if you can't explain it clearly and get your execs to actually want to use your model, it doesn't matter. Your code is just going to end up in some untouched GitHub repo and you'll lose 3 months worth of work. Top performers know how to drive clear, compelling stories with data. They're able to summarize an entire project into a one-slide takeaway that drives actual business decisions. For example, our model flagged a higher-risk segment projected to cost us $300,000 next quarter. We should work with a product team to improve onboarding for that group. Simple, clear, and actionable, and also tied back into a business outcome. Great storytelling turns good analysis into real business impact, and that is what's going to get you promoted. Moving on, we've got to talk about the technical side, because even with AI doing most of the grunt work, your technical skills still matter. If you want to be in the top 1%, you need to be sharp in SQL, confident in Python, and ready to adapt as AI and machine learning continue to reshape the data industry. To develop these skills, I wanted to share with you my favorite platform, DataCamp, who are kindly sponsoring this segment of the video. DataCamp is my go-to recommendation for anyone who wants to build some serious data skills fast. And I've actually been using it myself for over 6 years to keep sharpening my own skills. No matter what you're trying to learn, DataCamp has hundreds of courses designed to take you from beginner to advanced, and I love its interactive learning style, especially for coding skills like Python, R, and SQL. And you're able to do it all directly in your browser without having to download anything else. One of the tracks that I've actually been looking at lately is the Machine Learning Specialist Career Track in Python. It's packed with courses on deep learning, hyperparameter tuning, and natural language processing. But if you were just getting started, I would actually recommend beginning with the Associate Data Scientist Certification. This will cover all the essential skills that you will need as a data scientist, including Python, SQL, R, machine learning, and a bit of AI. And the program includes real-world projects so you can build confidence and apply what you've learned before attempting the certification exam and popping it onto your LinkedIn profile. Whether you are just starting out or already working in analytics, DataCamp has something for every level, and they're constantly updating their content to stay ahead of the curve. I will have both of these courses linked in my description box below. I highly recommend you checking out DataCamp, you won't regret it, and let's get back into the rest of the video. Moving on, you've probably heard me say this 100 times and it's definitely worth repeating. Attention to detail is one of the biggest things that separates junior analysts from the top 1% professionals. I personally am a perfectionist, and I take a lot of pride in my work, so this does come pretty naturally for me, and honestly, I think it's one of the things that helped me level up so quickly. Remember that your job isn't just to write code. It's to deliver trustworthy outputs. Look at your insights and question yourself. Do these numbers actually make sense? Before you send your recommendations out, pause and ask, what is the first thing my stakeholder is going to question? This isn't just about avoiding mistakes, it's about building credibility. Because here's a reality, one bad insight can ruin your reputation, and you don't want to be known as that one person in the team that always gets all their numbers wrong. When people trust your work, they trust your recommendations, and that is what's going to get you real influence and get promoted quickly. And owning the insight is only part of the job. The top 1% don't just stop at, here's the data. They own the entire process, from scoping, to analysis, to delivery, and to follow-up. Don't just build the dashboard, check if anyone's actually using it. What is the feedback loop? Did it drive any action, and what can be improved? I would recommend that you treat every project like a mini product, that you are responsible for its success. This mindset builds trust, shows leadership, and creates career momentum. And here's the thing, data investigations can sometimes be paralyzing, endless edge cases, waiting on clarity. But top performers don't wait, they move, even when things aren't perfect. Are you able to prototype something and iterate quickly? Because the ability to navigate ambiguity, make decisions, and still drive value, that's what separates your top 1% from everyone else. Moving on, the data world moves quickly. AI, no-code platforms, vibe coding, you name it. Expectations change, and your skill set needs to keep up. The things that got you hired 5 years ago might not be enough today. The top 1% don't coast. They're always asking, what's changing? New tools, new trends, and what can I do to stay ahead? So carve out some time every week to test out some new tools, watch a couple YouTube videos, or read up on some industry blogs. And lastly, don't be a know-it-all. Sounds obvious, but you'd be surprised. Execs don't care if you trained a regularized XG model with stratified cross-validation. They just care about what the model means for the business. Say it simply, make it useful, because that's what's going to get you noticed. So if you're serious about getting promoted and being the top 1% data professional, focus on how you think, how you communicate, how you execute, and most importantly, how you show up. Because it's not just about learning more tools. It's about becoming the kind of person that other people want to work with, promote, and trust with business critical problems. Now, if you would like to understand exactly what I do at work as a data scientist, feel free to check out this video up on the screen. I never know which side to point at. Thank you again to Data Camp for sponsoring today's video. I hope that you learned something and that it was helpful. And as always, take care, stay safe, and I will see you in my next video. Bye-bye.